In this video, we will be talking about conditional probability and looking at problem 5.44. Conditional probability. A conditional probability is the probability an event will occur given some event has already occurred. What we're saying is we're not simply looking for the chance that one thing happened. We're looking for the chance that something happened given some first thing happened. For instance, if you hear that somebody got into a car wreck and their car flipped over 25 times and they managed to walk out of their car unscathed, you would say, man, you were really lucky. Are you saying they were really lucky to get in a car wreck? No. What you're saying is, given that they were in a car wreck and their car flipped over 35 times, they were lucky that they walked out unscathed. You're stating a probability based on something else that has already happened. That is a conditional probability. Here is the way that we write this notationally. We will say the probability of A, and we'll use just a vertical line here, then B. We read this as... the probability of A given B has occurred. All right. And we define it thusly, the probability of A given B is equal to the probability of A intersect B, we say A and B, divided by the probability of this event B. And I like to think about this sort of looks like a fraction, and this would be the denominator. Here you see the probability of event B, that is the denominator. Let's see if we can illustrate this with a Venn diagram and an example we talked about previously. Example. Okay, let's say we have some student that's finished a two-year college and they're now going to try to get into a four-year college, and they have a couple of colleges they're interested in. Let's say that SH is the event that they gained admittance to Sam Houston State. Admitted to Sam Houston State University. Okay, and let's let B be admitted to Baylor. All right, and let's say that the probability that this person gets admitted to Sam Houston is 50%, 0.5. And Baylor's a little tougher to get into. The probability that they get admitted into Baylor is 40%. And the probability that they're going to gain admittance to both of them, Sam Houston intersect Baylor, this is Sam Houston and Baylor, is 0.3. Okay. Let's see if we can create a Venn diagram to help us analyze this situation. If you haven't watched the video on intersection and union, you should do so prior to this discussion. All right, we want two intersecting circles. Those are awful circles. This circle on the left will be the Sam Houston event, admitted into Sam Houston. This will be the Baylor event. Recall that we first do our intersection. The overlap, the Sam Houston and Baylor, that's 30%. I'm going to put 0.3 in here. So this portion in here is indicating that 30% of the time they will be admitted to Sam Houston and to Baylor both. Okay. Well, if 50% of the time they're admitted to Sam Houston, but we already have this 30, then this remaining area is 0.2. This event is Sam Houston, but not Baylor. Well, if Baylor's 40% and we've already accommodated for 30, then the remainder would be 0.1. This event here would be Baylor, but not Sam Houston, 10% of the time. Well, what remains out here? Well, this is 20 and 30 is 50%, and 10 more 60%, so out here is 40. This is neither Sam Houston nor Baylor. Maybe some other school, or maybe no school at all. Okay, so let's look at a couple of these events that we're just now describing. I want to look at the probability that our person gets into Sam Houston given that they've gotten into Baylor. We'll look at the definition. The definition says the probability of A given B is the intersection divided by, let this be the denominator. Okay, so I'm just going to use just replace the S's and H's for the SH and the B's for the A and the B's here. So the numerator we have the intersection. It's the probability of Sam Houston intersect Baylor. And the denominator is the Baylor, the whole probability of Baylor. All right, now we can figure this out. What is the probability of Sam Houston intersect Baylor? Well, that's that 0.3, and we had it here anyway, 0.3. Well, what is the probability of Baylor? Well, that's this whole circle, 0.3 and 0.1, it's 0.4. We knew that anyway there, 0.4. What is 0.3 divided by 0.4? Well, that's 3/4. That's 75%. I'm going to write it as a percentage in this case, 75%. That is, the probability that the person gets into Sam Houston, given they have gotten into Baylor, is 75%. This makes sense. If we know that they've gotten, assuming that they've have applied to both schools, if we know that they've gotten into Baylor, well, that totally eliminates this whole 0.4 out here. If we know that they've gotten into Baylor, that gives us some additional information. It tells us that they weren't out here and did not get in. Thus, we're only dealing with this portion. Of this portion, the intersection is this 0.3. So it's 0.3 out of this entire 0.4. You see, it's a 75% chance. Knowing we got into Baylor gave us some additional information about whether or not they would get into Sam Houston. All right, let's look at the other conditional. The probability that our person will get into Baylor given they've gotten into Sam Houston. Well, the numerator will be the same because this is much like multiplication, is commutative. This intersection, this B intersect SH, these two quantities are the same. Okay, the order doesn't matter up there. And the denominator this time is my Sam Houston probability. Okay, so my B intersect SH is the same as SH intersect B, it's 0.3. Okay, but what's my probability for Sam Houston? Well, it's 0.5. Now this division, 0.3 divided by 0.5 is 0.6 or 60%. Again, you can see my percentage went up. The probability of getting into Baylor outright is 40%, but given I've gotten into Sam Houston, the probability of getting in Baylor is 60%. Why is that? Again, if I know that I've gotten into Sam Houston, then I'm not ever out here and then not getting in anywhere. If I've gotten into Sam Houston, I'm in this 50% area. The overlap is this 30%. Well, this 0.3 over this entire 0.5 is 60%. Let's look at a couple of things. First, these probabilities are not the same. Okay? And that makes sense. These events they're not going to be independent. If we know we've gotten into Baylor, and Baylor was our harder school to get into, it makes sense that this probability would be greater than this one, this 75% chance. Knowing we got into Sam Houston, that was information, but it was not as compelling information as knowing we got into Baylor. So we see this. These probabilities here are not equal. But both of these are increases over the previous one because we have knowledge that we have gained admittance into some school.